Hi, it's Michael from Men's Finest, and today we are talking green grass, white outfits, and some good shots. Yes, you've guessed it, Wimbledon is on. So in today's video, we're going to look at five style icons that play tennis. Also, we're going to have a look at tennis sweaters, jumpers, and whether they have got its place and time in 2017. That's my opinion. What's yours? Comment below. Comment below. So first of all, what do you think about tennis jumpers, tennis sweaters? Do you think that they should be as part of your wardrobe? I've seen that trend coming up recently. I've seen it in a few sort of high street shops. And you know, it's grown on me slowly. I have seen The Guardian also talked about this in their article, that you have to be careful where you use it and how you use it, so you don't end up looking like you're trying too hard. But I think if you have got the right combination of trousers and collars, that tennis sweater and jumper could actually play to your advantage. I want to talk to you about some style icons, because over the years, tennis players have become a bit of a style icons. Do you remember that guy? Andre Agassi? He's my number five. I think he changed a lot of things in tennis. My number four is going to be Roger Federer. It's not because he's the most exciting player of all, but probably because he has got this sort of contemporary take on how he dresses. He never overcooked things. He's always subtle and stable. He's that sort of kind of premium look attire. Everything that he releases has got that sort of higher end when he releases a set of clothes or set of perfumes or set of, you know, tennis rackets or whatever else. Who possibly could be number three? And of course, that has to be John McEnroe. Johnny is a character. I absolutely love him. I remember as a kid watching Joe McEnroe. My dad used to hate him, but I always loved him. I think the fact that he was so passionate about the game. And thank you so much, Joe McEnroe. I know you've shouted a thing or two at other people and other players. I respect you for that. Not many people know that René Lacoste and Fred Perry were actually two very good tennis players. Lacoste, the guy who created Lacoste, and Fred Perry, the guy who created Fred Perry. In fact, Fred Perry was the first guy that actually was wearing headband, and more people afterward sort of started to copy him, but he was the first person to do that on a tennis court. Number two's got to be Arthur Ashe. He was absolutely impeccably dressed on court and off court. You can find his pictures of sort of being a bit of a style icon back in the 70s, and you can easily sense that he was from the 70s. You look at his pictures and you can't believe how 70s were a not so long ago, but how cool they actually were. There is only one guy that could be number one. That's Bjorn Borg, a Swedish champion off and on court. If you look at his off-court pictures, they are just mind-blowing. So I think we owe Bjorn for more than just a tennis game. We owe him for being such a stylish man and bringing the style and class to us normal people. Five most stylish people. There you have it. That's my opinion. What's yours? Comment below. Comment below. Do you agree with that list? Who else you would include in that list? Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, the Wimbledon is on. Watch it. We're just on the first rounds, but before you know, it's going to be a final. So don't miss it. Stay stylish. Speak to you soon.